Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JR from PTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you three Photoshop hacks that you probably don't know. If this is your first time at the Photoshop Training Channel, don't forget to click on that subscribe button. Okay, let's get started. The first Photoshop hack is creating templates. I have this file here, which is a PSD, the default Photoshop file format, and it's a template that I use to create my daily Photoshop tip, and it's an image that ends up on Pinterest. So I'm going to open it up so you could see it. There it is. I just change the text and save it as a JPEG. And this is a template file that I use. And a lot of people have template Photoshop files that they use for repetitive tasks. It doesn't have to be social media posts. It could be anything. Now, I want you to notice one thing. On the tab, you'll see the name of the file, Photoshop Tip 2017xxx.psd. And if I make a change to this template and close it, Photoshop is going to ask me to save this original template file. And if I accidentally click on yes, then I will have made changes to the template. And that's not something you always want to do, because if you adjust the template, then you have to fix it next time you open it. So that can become a problem. So instead, what I recommend doing is going into your PSD that you use as a template and rename it and add a different file extension. Instead of PSD, we're going to use a PSDT and just add that letter on there. Your operating system will ask you if you want to change the file extension. Click on yes. Notice that the icon changes. If we open it up now, it's going to look exactly the same. But the one difference is that it's no longer that same file. Now it's an untitled file. So that's what a PSDT does. It opens an untitled new version of the document that you're working with. So you can never overwrite that original template. This is actually the same format that Adobe stock templates use. So you never work with the original. You always work with a new untitled instance. This is the file format that I recommend using if you use Photoshop PSDs as templates. In hack number two, I'm going to show you how to use a custom plugins folder with Photoshop CC. Actually, in older versions of Photoshop, Adobe allowed you to use a custom plugins folder to install all of your plugins. Unfortunately, starting with CC, that's no longer the case, but there is a hack to get around that. I'm here in my programs folder. If I go into the Adobe folder, you'll see all the Adobe applications that I have installed. I'm going to open up my Photoshop CC 2017 folder, and I'm going to go into the plugins folder. You will see that I have a plugin from Google called Knit Collection. Now, this is not specific to this particular plugin. It'll work with any plugins, but the only one I have installed currently is Knit Collection. And if I open it up, you'll see that there's a whole bunch of files that make up the plugin. Now, if I uninstall Photoshop, then the files will also be uninstalled. If I upgrade to a newer version of Photoshop, then the files will be in this installation, not the new one. So sometimes it's best to have a custom folder where you put all your plugins. What you need to do is just delete the files that are in this folder because we don't need them anymore. I'm going to go into a folder where I have the plugins. Here they are. And just to be clear, you will have to copy over the files from the Photoshop folder onto a different location, but I did it before recording the video. But here it is in this folder, which is not in the Adobe Photoshop folder, as you can see here. And I can just simply create a shortcut or an alias if you're using a Mac. And there's my shortcut here. Now I'm going to go back to the Adobe Plugins folder, and I'm going to click and drag that shortcut onto it. There it is. I have Photoshop closed, and I'm opening that up now. I'm going to create a new document and click on Create. And there it is. And if I go into Filter, you will see my Knit Collection plugins are here. And I can select that and it turns on. And as you can see, it's working. Obviously, I have a white background. It's not really doing much, but the plugin works. And all we're using is a shortcut to that folder. If I were to upgrade to a new version of Photoshop, all I need to do is create another shortcut and drag it onto the new plugins folder, or just copy this shortcut onto there. But the plugins will always be there on that separate folder. So once again, if you're working on an older version in Photoshop CC, you don't have to worry about this because there is an option in the preferences panel that allows you to select a custom plugins folder. In hack number three, I'm going to show you how to get more lookup tables. And what I mean by that is if you create a new color lookup adjustment layer, you have these LUT files that you can select to apply a different look onto the image. So we can select AJ Amber or any of the other LUT files that we have. If you're a member of the Creative Cloud, you can take advantage of extra LUT files that are included in those other applications. I'm going to minimize Photoshop, and here I am in the Adobe folder that contains all the different Adobe applications that I have installed in this computer. If I go into Premiere Pro, then select Lumetri, inside of that we have a LUTS folder with three different folders. You can try Legacy, for example, sort them by type. Cube are the ones that we're going to be able to take onto Photoshop. So we can do something like this one here. I can do them all, but I'm just going to copy one so that you can see how it works. So I'm going to copy that, go back into my Adobe folder, open Photoshop, and under presets, there is a 3D LUT folder, and you can paste that in there. And here it is. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to rename it, and I'm just going to add Z hyphen so that it moves to the bottom of the list. Then I'm going to need to close Photoshop, and I need to open it up again. And the image that I was using was in my libraries panel, so I'm going to open that up, and we'll use the same image that we were using before. I'm going to double click on it to open it. Then I'm going to go into color lookup, click on the drop down, and notice here at the very bottom we have this Z hyphen panalog 4 to linear cube. That's a different effect that LUT file creates, and you can come back into that Adobe folder and you can look at Adobe Premiere Pro once again and select any of the other files found in the Lumetri LUT folder. Once again, not all the files would work, but if you're using cube files, they should work in Photoshop. And I have an extra bonus hack for you. This one deals with layer masks. I'm going to click on the quick selection tool, and I'm going to click and drag to make a selection around the sky. As you know, in Photoshop CC, you have the select and mask workspace. You can click on this button here to bring that up, and you can adjust the edge of your selection with these sliders. The selected mask workspace was introduced in Photoshop CC 2015, and many people prefer the old refine edge dialog. If you prefer to work with it, you can actually bring it back. Go into select, hold shift, then click on select and mask, and that brings up the old refine edge dialog box. So if you prefer to work with it, this is how you can bring it back. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. If you enjoyed this tutorial, share this video with a friend, click on that like button, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.